Hi, Chloe. Nice to meet you.
I'm Claire. I'm going to be your social worker.
Okay, nice to meet you.
Yeah, so how did you get in today?
It was fine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did you just take a bus? Or?
Yeah.
Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah. Not too much traffic?
No, it was okay.
Oh, that's perfect.
Yeah.
The weather's pretty gloomy, so it's good you weren't walking.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah.
All right.
So just before we get started, I kind of just wanted to go over kind of our roles and expectations for what's going to happen.
Okay.
So one thing that I wanted to make clear is that if I see you outside of this client social worker relationship, I probably won't acknowledge you as a client, and that's just to make sure that we're having a professional relationship. So if you speak to me, then I will respond, but I might not be as I might not engage in conversation. And so basically, just to give you a little heads up for what we're going to be doing, today we're just going to kind of go over the basics of your situation right now and kind of how life's going right now. And then in the future, we'll have other sessions where we'll talk more about the future-oriented goals and expectations and things you want to accomplish out of this.
Okay.
Yeah. So kind of to start off with, I'm going to go over some of some considerations that I think are important. One is that everything we're going to be talking about today is going to be confidential, which means I will be the only one who will hear what you are talking about. However, there are going to be a few exceptions to that, and I'll go over those. So one is that I have a duty to warn if I find out that you are going to be a danger to yourself or to others. And I also have a duty to warn if I find out that you, about any abuse or neglect from you. And then another thing that I will also be telling other people possibly is I'll be talking to my supervisor about what we talk about in this session. And that's mostly just to help me frame it or analyze what we're doing better and analyze how we can move forward in a better manner so that we can better work together. And then also I might tell other people about what we're talking about in here, but within those circumstances I will ask your permission specifically, and we can talk about specifically what you're comfortable with me sharing and what you aren't comfortable with me sharing. So that's just to make sure we're on the same page.
Okay.
Does that sound all right to you?
Yeah.
That's fine. Perfect. All right. So can you tell me a little bit about your situation right now, what's going on in your life?
I don't really want to be here right now, to be honest, but basically I'm here because I'm truant.
Okay.
At my high school. I missed a lot of days of school.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, can you tell me a little bit about some of your relationships right now? Do you talk a lot with your family members, or?
I hang out with my sister a lot and look after her.
Nice. Okay.
Yeah.
And what about other family members? Can you tell me a little bit about your relationship with them?
Well, my mom is not in my life right now, but my dad works all the time, so I don't see him a lot,
So it sounds like you hang out a lot with your sister, but not as much with both of your parents, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, can you tell me a little bit about why that is with your parents' relationship?
Why I don't hang out with them? I mean, my mom left us when I was younger, so that's why I don't hang out with her. And I don't know where she is right now, to be honest.
Okay.
But my dad works all the time. Mm-hmm. He is gone, like, 6 in the morning until 7 at night.
Okay.
And then he usually goes back to work. So I don't really see him.
Yeah, so it's more of a time constraint with you.
Yeah.
When you do spend time with your dad, what's that like?
It's like distant, I guess I would say. Mm-hmm. We don't really talk.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. And can you tell me a little bit about how your mother kind of became separated from the family? What happened?
Yeah. Well, she was an alcoholic, mm-hmm. and my dad eventually just kicked her out.
Okay.
Because she couldn't keep it together.
Mm-hmm. And how many years ago was that?
That was 5 years ago.
Okay.
And I haven't seen her since.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sometimes she asks for money, though.
Oh, okay.
My dad, but he didn't give her anything.
Mm-hmm. And how do you feel about that relationship?
I I mean, she chose to not come back, so I'm okay with it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it sounds like you feel like your relationship with your parents is kind of distant in both respects. Just because of your mom's situation with alcoholism, and also with your dad's situation with work, and kind of just feeling distant even when you are around him.
Yeah.
And what about at school? How are your relationships there? Do you feel like you have good friends, close friends?
Not really. Yeah. I mean, I just started at a new school.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know, there's not that many people I like at my school.
Mm-hmm.
And the people I do like is in my art class, and that's only 1 hour of the day.
Okay, well that's great that you are enjoying people in your art class.
Thank you.
Sounds like you're really allowing yourself to explore new relationships there, which is great.
Thank you.
Yeah. What about your art class do you think makes you more open to
it?
That's a bad question. Okay, sorry, go ahead.
I don't know, I guess I just like talking to people about art. It's like something I've always been interested in. And people always in that class have a lot to say.
Mm-hmm.
And I like my art teacher.
Nice. That's great. Yeah. Huh. Well, very cool. And what about your art teacher do you like?
She's really interesting. She's she studied in like New York City, and so she has a lot of like experience with art.
Mm-hmm.
Knows a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And like is a nice person, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's great. What, have you talked to her a lot about her experiences, or what have you learned from her?
I don't know, basically what I said, but like,
mm-hmm.
She lived in like Greece and Rome and all these places for a long time,
mm-hmm.
So she has a lot of like life experiences, I guess.
Yeah. Wow, that's really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. What's the question? So can you tell me a little about your relationships with your other teachers?
Yeah, so I guess, I don't know, I really like my English class.
Mm-hmm.
I really like reading, and I don't know, like learning about different countries and stuff.
Yeah, that's great.
Mm-hmm. But I don't really like the kids in that class that much. I just like the teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And math, which sucks. Math is the worst.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely struggled in math in high school too, so I get that feeling.
Yeah, it's so boring.
Yeah.
And bio,
mm-hmm.
which is a little more interesting than math, but
not
that interesting.
Yeah. Well, it sounds like you're really doing well in the subjects that you thrive in, and I think that's really great that you're putting yourself into those, and that's great.
Thank you.
And also with science that you're still trying there, even though sometimes you don't always find it interesting.
Thank you.
It's really good. So just to summarize kind of what we went through in this session, so we first went over kind of the ethical responsibilities, how this relationship is going to go in the future, and then you also told me a little bit about your family, how your parents are both kind of distant in your life. Your mom is an alcoholic, and she's kind of out of the picture, although she sometimes comes back in to ask for money and things. And
yeah, she sucks.
Oh, okay. Sorry. And your dad works a lot, so you don't see him very often. But you have a stronger relationship with your sister and also with your art teacher, it sounds like. And you're really enjoying your art and writing classes, which is great. That's really great.
Thank you.
Awesome. Well, it was really great to meet you, Chloe. And
thank you.
Yeah, I look forward to seeing you next week.
Thanks.
Thank you.